Welcome to today's edition of 3 Minutes of Halacha. Yesterday we began to discuss the question of the Birkot Kriyat Shema, the brachot that we say prior to and following the Shema itself. Today, I want to address a fascinating piece within the first two brachot, between them, and that is the Kedusha DeYotzer, the first of three Kedushot, of three statements of Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh Hashem Tzvakot, that we say during the davening. The first is now, when we report of the way the malachim, the angels, would say this kedusha to God in the heavens. The Avodrom points out that the reason for this is because we want to reaffirm that God controls the entire universe, even over the malachim, the angels themselves. The second kedusha we will encounter in Shmoneh Esrei, the classic kedusha that we actually say. And the third will be the Kedusha that we encounter in Uval Etzion, where we interpret these three psukim that are part of the Kedusha, translating them with explanation into Aramaic. This Kedusha, according to the Levush, is supposed to be said out loud. The Kedusha at Yotzer, we should say Kadosh, 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 together and out loud, emulating the way the Malachim, the angels, recited in the heavens. There is a machloket as well about this Kedusha, whether it should be said standing or sitting. After all, the classic Kedusha of Shmoneh Esrei has to be said while you're standing. And in fact, that was the position of the Shla, even when it came to this Kedusha of Yotzer. The Yavetz, however, disagreed. And he said, no, that this is only a description. It's a sipur of what was taking place. And therefore, we can sit during this. The third issue comes with the question of whether or not you need a minyan. In other words, if you're davening by yourself, can you say this Kedusha? Obviously, when it comes to the Kedusha of Shmoneh Esrei, we only say it with a minyan. And when it comes to the Kedusha of Uval Etzion, there it's actually an experience of learning about them, the translation and the explanation. So it would not be a classic kind of Kedusha. But what about this one? The Rambam was actually of the position that you would skip this if you don't have a minyan. The Rashbam, however, found a middle ground, and he said it should be sung with a tune. The tune we assume is referring to is the trump of the Torah, or the Nach, where it contains the words of Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh. However, the Rambam disagrees, and the Rambam takes the position of the earlier Balei HaTosfot, that this can be said as we do, even when davening alone. Interestingly, the Mishneh Berurah, however, does point out that even though we follow the position of the Rambam, still, if you're saying it by yourself, you should take that middle compromise approach of the Rashba and say this Kedusha with an element of song. The Igrot Moshe says it doesn't have to be the trup. Rather, in Yoredeah Chelek Gimel, the third volume of Yoredeah, Simen Chof Aleph, but Moshe says it could even be sung with the same song you might use when learning Torah. One final thought. These three Kedushot as a set actually offered for us a fascinating lesson in education. Because first we describe, we give a model of how Kedusha is said by the angels. Then we do it ourselves. And then we give the explanation. All too often people think that before they need to do something in religious life, they need to understand it. What these three Kedushot teach us is, look at the role models in your life, emulate them, perform the mitzvot, and then continue performing them while you learn the depths and understanding of what those mitzvot, what the Kedusha is all about.